Now this pathway hormone is like in your sort of relations. Then what is going to happen? Okay, the pathway hormones will go to places, right? Okay, one thing it can go to is, let's say it will go to the bones, okay? And you guys remember these bones here, osteoblasts. The bones are different types of cells, right? They're osteoblasts and osteoclasts. Those are the main types of cells, okay? And we'll discuss about that. Because there are different types of cells too. This, when they go to the cells, these pathway hormones are receptors on the osteoblast cells. And remember, this osteoblast is what? It is known as your bone building cells, okay? There are different types of receptors, like pathway hormone 1, 2 receptors and all, okay? But when they come, this is again, with the bound with the 7 pass membrane receptors, okay? That's what's going to happen. 7 paths, but this is actually the GS path, okay? They're going to go, and then they're going to look. With the GS path, what is going to happen? The GTP will bound with the GS, right? And then it's going to stimulate the domain of your adrenal cyclase, right? And then what is going to happen ultimately? It's going to convert ATP into cyclic AMP, and then the cyclic AMP will act, protein kinase, right? They'll activate certain genes, okay? Mercenaries, and what is going to produce? Ultimately, what is that going to produce? What they're going to produces so-called as your ODF, okay? Or we can simply say rank L, okay? Or even some other proteins like interleukin 6, okay? And also like osteo, okay? Protagrin. This is a family of proteins, okay? This is osteoprotagrin. It's basically a family of proteins of your tumor necrosing factors, okay? And they have very, very important functions of this, okay? Because what they do is that they decrease the mobilizations of these are calcium and phosphorus. That's what they do, okay? And then this one is your osteogenesis differentiating factors, okay? That's what ODF. Or we can simply call this a rank L too. Rank L is basically it's a activity of receptors of a nuclear kappa. Okay, it's a nuclear kappa. That's already. And this guys, this rank L or this osteogenesis differentiating factor is the same thing. They have receptors on your osteoclast cells. Okay, so they have receptors on osteoclast cells. So when they will go and stimulate the receptor, what is going to happen is that because there's a receptor like rank L receptor, let's just say. Okay, this is a rank receptor for the rank ligand to go and bind into this. Okay, when the rank L is going to go bind, it will stimulate the cells. Okay, and ultimately, what is going to happen is that these cells will start working, and this cell starts showing its effect. Okay, what is going to happen is these cells will actually start producing integrins, and those integrins will be like so-called your beta integrins. Okay, those beta integrins will come and it will put a seal here. Okay, let's just say it will put a seal. This is called sealing off. Okay. That's what's going to happen first. And remember, inside the bones, what do you guys have, guys? Remember, bones has what? A lot of collagen, right? Let's just make this a lot of collagen right here. Okay? A lot of collagen right here, right? We'll make the three types of collagen. And what is the collagen? Like, what type of collagen? This is a collagen type of 1, right? And then collagen, what is deposited here? You guys remember this, right? They have a calcium here, they have a phosphate here, calcium here, phosphate here, calcium here, phosphate here. And whenever there's a deposit of calcium and phosphate, okay, there's in the form of, okay, their deposits are calcium and phosphate, okay? And the way the deposit is, like, they have, like, the C, okay? A C10, like, and then, you know, PO4, like, 6OH2, okay? It is something like this, okay? So this is basically means that it's a hydroxy epitope. That's what they call, okay? The depositions of these calciums in this collagen fibers, okay? We call this as a hydroxy epitope, okay? That's in the form of, because whenever the calcium and phosphate are bound together in the collagen, okay? Because collagen is organic, right? And they have those prolines and the glycine, okay? That's what the collagen is made out of, right? Now, anyways, so what is going to happen is that when the calcium comes in here, okay? So when they are sealing off, let's say it puts a sealing off here, okay? By the beta integrins, okay? And then after that, what is going to happen is that the lysosome enzymes will start fusing here, okay? When the lysosome enzyme was fusing here, what is going to happen is that, okay, they start releasing hydrolytic enzymes, okay? So what is going to happen? These cells will start releasing hydrolytic enzymes. So when the cells have hydrolytic releasing enzymes, what is going to happen? Proteolysis will happen, meaning that it will start breaking down. Not only that, what's going to happen? The cell will increase the activity of your proton pump, okay? There's a proton pump here. Increase of, like, let's say, your proton ATPase, which basically means is that there's a lot of that lot of acid. They will make this environment very, very acidic, okay? And whenever there is a lot of those acidic environments are created, what is going to happen? There are different types of protein, like a collagen or cathepsin, okay? Like let's write a collagen here, or even cathepsin, okay? This protein will come, and they will start breaking this down, okay? And when you start breaking down, what is going to happen? What is going to come along with this, okay? The circulations. Let's write it down here, okay? What is going to come in the circulation, guys? It's going to come out. Let's just write it down here, okay? You're going to have a, okay, your calcium coming out. You've got a phosphate is coming out. At the same time, you have an alkaline phosphate. Alkaline phosphatase is also coming down. And whenever you see a lot of this alkaline phosphatase in your plasma, that is a marker of this bone breaking down, okay? The mobilization of the calcium is happening. That's what is going to happen in a bone's level, okay? Because right now, what is going to happen? Calcium level is falling down, okay? And what do we want to do? We want to reabsorb the calcium, and we want to increase the plasma level of calcium. Because remember, whatever calcium level, which is ionized form, that's the biologically active form, right? So that's what, this is the role of bath hormone does in the bones, okay? Now, we have a calcium and phosphate in your extracellular fluid, okay? Now, after this, what is going to happen is calcium. Now, this is calcium here. The calcium is here, okay? And calcium phosphate, alkaline phosphatase, all of them are here. Not only this, you know, the bath hormone does this, the bath hormone also has receptors located in your kidney, okay? But before even we go over there, I'm going to quickly talk about some of the stuff, okay? One thing that I will quickly want to talk about is osteopotegrin, okay? I'm going to quickly talk about this. The reason why, because there's a ratio of this osteopotegrin versus this rank L, okay? The reason why is because this osteopotegrin, it can inhibit this, okay? So that way, it is basically what it is doing. It is, you know, it is regulating to, you know, not able to do the destructions of the bone, okay? That's what this osteopotegrin is doing. And this is a very, very important protein. The reason why I mentioned this is, guys, you know, bath hormone, what it does? It, bath hormones, or like cortisol or glucocorticoids, you know, based by these receptors, what is it doing? It is basically what it decreases the expressions of this osteopotegrin. Okay, that's what it does. Let's write down cortisol here, okay? And then we'll write down cortisol, and then we'll write down bath hormones, okay? It is doing, okay, let's write rank, okay, L over osteopotegrin, okay? So what is it doing? It increases the, okay, the rank L and decreasing the expressions of osteopotegrin. One more thing. Estrogen, okay, I have to mention this, very, very important. What does estrogen does? Estrogen, what is it? It actually increases the expressions of this osteoprotegrin. That's what it does. That's the reason why women, okay, after menopause, okay, they get those hot flashes, okay, because they're and then they get those hip fractures because they go through something called osteoporosis, okay. The reason why they go to osteoporosis is because their estrogen level goes down, okay, and because the estrogen level goes down, what is going to happen is that this expressions of osteoprotegrin is decreased, okay? So because they decrease, they no longer can actually stimulate this rank L. So that way it does not causes this osteocytic osteolysis, okay? Osteolysis. Because basically this is result into, you know, those osteoporosis, okay? Whenever this expressions of this osteoprotegrin is decreased, okay? And that I want to quickly actually and insinuate into this, and this is very, very important, okay? So now, after this, okay, and guys, just know this, osteocytic osteolysis is basically the breaking down, okay, these bones, you know, mobilizing calcium and phosphate, okay, due to the path of hormones. This process is, okay, this is a rapid process is known as osteocytic osteolysis, okay? Lysis means what you're breaking down, okay? And you know these cells, right? This osteoclast cells. Osteoclast cells are what? Osteoclast cells are macrophages. You guys know this, right? Osteoclast cells are macrophages. These guys are what? The monocyte derivatives, right? That's what is going to happen. So whenever there's an increased level of bath hormones, this osteoclast also actually secretes, you know, those monocyte stimulating factors and all, okay? Or growth factors, okay? So that way, this guy can go to the bone marrow house and start producing, you know, more of this osteoclast cells, monocyte cells, okay? And they can come here and do this function, okay? That also happens. That's just quickly extra that I'm giving it to you. But let me quickly summarize here, okay? Remember, the parathyroid hormone comes here, okay? Low level of calcium increases your parathyroid hormone secretions, okay? The parathyroid hormone comes to circulation. Parathyroid hormone goes to bones, okay? But parathyroid hormone receptor is not located in osteoclast. It's located on the osteoblast cell. It is stimulates the osteoblast cells. Then the osteoblast cells will produce this rank, okay, the rank L. And then those rank L has a receptor osteoclast cells, okay? They're stimulated in such a way that they will start producing the ceiling off by producing these beta integrins, okay? And the cell also produces lysosomal enzymes, okay? And then the hydrolytic enzymes, and they'll make this environment so acidic by increasing the your proton ATPase pump as well, okay? And after that, due to collagenase or cathepsins proteins, okay, what is gonna happen? They'll start breaking down this collagenase, okay, which has this hydroxyapatite bound into it, okay? Calcium phosphate deposit, or we can say hydroxyapatite crystals are there, okay? And then the mobilizations of the calcium happens, okay? Because remember, bones are known for depositions and mobilizations, right? Reabsorption, that's what is happening. And what are we doing right now? We're doing a resorption, right? That's what we're doing from here. Now calcium and alkaline phosphatase and calcium phosphatase and alkaline phosphatase is in your plasma, right?